everyone, my name is Udit. Today I'm going to talk a little bit about the Amazon Technical Program Manager phone interview process. At the end of this video, you should have a really good understanding of what the phone interview looks like for this role, what interviewers are assessing in this round, some sample questions of each type that they ask, as well as some tips to prepare for this. As a quick introduction, I'm from Prepfully. We offer online anonymous mock interviews with someone who's worked in your target company and role, alongside a host of other interview prep services. In this context, we've got a lot of Amazon TPMs who've been helping candidates with mocks and advice, and they're also the ones who've helped us put together relevant content such as this video. So, on to the Amazon TPM phone interview then. This is step 2 in the TPM interview journey at Amazon, and it comes right after your recruiter screen. Let's discuss the format first because it's pretty standard for this round. The interview is roughly 60 minutes long and is broken down into 3 broad sections of about 20 minutes each. The first section is a test of your program management skills. The second section is all about technical questions. And the third is all behavioral and situational questions. Now, what's the interviewer really trying to assess in these? Their goal is to get a high-level assessment of your skills across all 3 domains. So in the first section, your interviewer is going to deep dive into your experience as a TPM. This usually starts off with a pretty broad question, such as tell me about a technical program that you've managed recently. Your interviewer is interested in learning about the work you did, how you drove things forward, what decisions you made, maybe the stuff you unblocked or influenced, and what lessons you learned from it all. And their questions are going to reflect this intent. So they'll often take the shape of what could you do differently if you had to do things all over again? Or what were some of the challenges you faced from the different teams involved in this program? In the second type of question, the focus is going to be all on technical aspects. So you could get asked a high-level architecture or system design question, although there's limited time in this interview, so you're not going to deep dive to the same extent that you will in your on-site. If you mentioned engineering skills as a possibility, you might be asked to demonstrate this through coding, although this does not happen very often. And you can also get asked technical know-how questions. A sample here question could be, what's a really complex architectural decision that you've been part of in the past? Or sometimes things can be slightly theoretical in nature. A good example is, how would you design a URL sharing service for Amazon products? In the third part of the interview, they're going to try and test your alignment with Amazon's famous leadership principles. Each of these LPs has a large number of possible questions associated with them, and your interviewer is usually going to have 2 or 3 LPs that they're going to try to detect your fit for. The questions are accordingly going to reflect this. So if your role potentially needs to index really heavily on taking charge and driving things forward, they might ask a question around own it. On the flip side, maybe you're going to be involved in managing a program with a lot of maybe potentially controversial aspects, in which case they might dig into your ability to disagree and commit. If you'd like to practice sample questions across these leadership principles, there are lots on our website. So to keep things short, I'm just going to move on to the next section, which is on our tips for cracking this round. First tip, always make sure that you're really answering the question asked. It's super easy to forget that an interviewer said, tell me about a time, and then start answering in the hypothetical with, here's what I do if I face this in the future. In a technical question, make sure that you're clarifying or scoping the question. You're expected to ask intelligent questions, which help you narrow this focus down to something that's actually reasonable, given the time constraints that you have. Second tip, be extremely succinct. You need to cover a tremendous amount of ground in this interview, so you don't want to let just one topic hijack the entire conversation. When preparing, make sure you think of 2 or 3 stories across each leadership principle, where you can concisely draw upon them when needed. And they don't necessarily have to be unique stories for each principle. You'll probably have examples from your past which satisfy 5 or 6 leadership principles at a time. But make sure that you're not left hanging when they ask you a question about a principle, you're not ready for it. A good tactic here is just to create a story database in Google Sheets or something where you can look back at these key projects and map them to these leadership principles. I've included a link in the description below with a template for inspiration. Third and final tip is to practice. There's simply no replacement for good old-fashioned practice. Say your answers out loud to friends, to colleagues you trust, or best of all to an Amazon TPM who can actually give you feedback. Ask if you're demonstrating the skills they're interested in. Ask if you're actually covering ground in a robust manner. You can book one of these on Prepfully. We have a lot of Amazon TPMs who've been helping candidates who can also help you either fine-tune your leadership principles or just give you feedback on your readiness level. So then that's all from me. That's our guidance from Prepfully and our experts on rocking Amazon's TPM phone interview. Once you feel ready for some practice, or if you just want a sense check of your readiness, you can book one of these anonymous mock interviews with an Amazon TPM on Prepfully. There's a link in the description below. So there's a written guide which goes into a lot more depth. There's also information about other aspects of the Amazon interview process, like the writing exercise that some candidates get and how to like demonstrate technical competence and system design questions and so on. Feel free to check those out as well. If you have follow-up questions about this interview, please ask in the comments below and we'll make sure to answer. And if you found this video useful, please don't forget to like and subscribe. Thanks and good luck.
Thanks for watching the video. If you liked it, please subscribe. Our website is prepfully.com. We've got lots of interview questions there. You can also schedule a mock interview with one of our experts. You can find the link in the description below. All the best from us at Prepfully, and we hope you totally rock your interview.